Hi everyone, welcome to this Twinmotion tips and tricks video. Today we'll be looking at how you can customize your sky and your background with a custom sky dome. To do that, first I will come to the import dock, click on import and import my FBX file located here, staticmeshskydome.fbx. This file will be linked in the description of the video. Once I've imported my file, as you can see, we have a different sky. We just select my sky and click on F so I can easily visualize it. As you can see, it's just a basic sphere with a 360 image on it. My file has been imported in the center of the world, which is located over here, but my project is a bit shifted on my left. So we need to move first my sky in the middle of my project. My camera was roughly in the center of the parking lot over here, so I just select my sky sphere and move it roughly in this position. To come back to my project, I will just select any geometry and click on F to focus on it. So let's come back in our point of view, which was something like that. As you can see here on my sphere, I have a pretty sharp shadow. It's because right now, this sphere uses the standard Twinmotion material. And in this specific case, we would like to use a translucent material. You can find those materials inside the library. Scroll to the bottom in the translucent folder. I will simply drag and drop the white styrofoam material on my sphere. Once my material has been applied, now I just need to load the correct texture. So we'll come to the mode over here, click on open, and I will just look for my PNG texture. Same thing, the PNG will be also in the file that you can download in the description. So as you can see now, I don't have my sharp line anymore, but I can play with the translucency to even make the sky even brighter. Now, the position of the sun inside Twinmotion is something around here. I can just hide my sky dome to better see it. Now what I need to do is select my sky dome and just align the sun on my image with the sun inside Twinmotion. So I'm just going to use the rotate tool to rotate and to align roughly the position of the sun. Something like that. So as you can see now, we have a nice surrounding. The sky looks a bit better with this texture. And I can also now unhide my reflection probe to have also the reflection directly in the glass of my building. Again, now if I remove my sky and my reflection probe, this is the look before, and this is the look of my project. Yep. Unhide. And this is the look of my project just after. Now, where can you find those 360 texture? I switched to a website called HDR Haven. There is plenty of different kind of HDR texture over here. Twinmotion doesn't support directly HDRI texture, so we need to convert that as a PNG, but we'll see that in a second. As you can see, there is plenty of different kind of texture. What I did is just, I know that I wanted to have like a sunrise sunset mood, so I click on the sunrise and sunset folder, and I just grab the first image that I can. But you can, of course, choose whatever you want. Let's select, for example, this rural landscape one. In my previous download, I used an 8K image because I know that there is only one of those images present in my scene. Usually, we try to stick with 2K or 4K images for Twinmotion materials, but when you have a nice sky that takes a lot of space inside your viewport, you can go for 8K. So I'm just going to download this image and switch to Photoshop to convert it as a PNG. My texture has been loaded in Photoshop. I will just come now to Image, Mode, switch to 8-bit, click on OK, and now I will simply save this image as a PNG. And let's now load this image inside Twinmotion. To do that, I will again select my material. It's still selected, so I'll just come to the More and select my new image. As you can see here, the lighting is a bit different on this image, so we need to change the time of day on directly inside Twinmotion to make sure I can align my sun properly with this new texture. And same thing for the reflection probe, since I've changed the background image, I will need to update my probe. Now that you have finished with your sky dome, what you can do is save that directly inside your user library, so you can use the sky dome for every future project. We just click on add to user library. This will create a new entry in my user library. This will also create a .tmi file that I can share with everyone. This file will also be available directly in the description down below. And we will see in another tips and tricks video how you can load those TME files directly inside Twinmotion. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to follow us for more content and see you for the next one. Bye everyone!